Video is rolling. Check one, check two. Okay, let's make this happen correctly this time. How's it going, everybody? Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I kind of want to talk about the Sony a7 IV announcement that's going to be dropping tomorrow. And for those of you who haven't heard, Sony just released that there is a new camera coming. And if you've paid any attention to SonyAlphaRumors.com, then you know that they have been teasing the release of the Sony a7 IV for quite some time. So in today's video, I just want to talk about why I'm really excited about it and why I'm 99% sure that I'm going to purchase it, even though I already own the Sony a7 III and the Sony FX6. So why don't we just jump into it? I want to go over what these rumored specs are, what I'm really looking forward to, what I don't really care about, and what I would like to see improved, if possible. So right off the bat, it says that it will have a newly developed 33 megapixel sensor. Now this is a pretty big improvement from the Sony a7 III, which only had a 12 megapixel sensor that a lot of people complained about. And this is for photos, so if you are taking a lot of photos and your only goal is to put those on Instagram, then yeah, 12 megapixels is totally fine. But there are times where I do like to make prints of my work, and having a 33 megapixel sensor for photo is actually kind of a big deal. So I am excited to see that they did make that improvement for the Sony a7 IV. So I think what we're gonna see here is a blend of, you know, the photo features that we see in the a7 R series and then video features that we see in the a7 S. Obviously, it's not gonna be fully capable like those cameras are, because then those cameras would be out of business, essentially. Another thing that they talk about is a new Bion ZXR processor sensor, which I don't know much about, to be honest, but with that includes 15 plus stops of dynamic range. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but the Sony a7 III, I believe, only has about 13 stops of dynamic range. So if this truly does have 15 plus stops, I'm really excited to see what that looks like, and especially shooting outdoors, which is kind of, you know, why I have a small camera like the Sony a7 III in the first place. So I'm really excited to see what that looks like. In terms of video, it's going to do 4K 30, and that is going to be oversampled from a 7K image. So we should be seeing a lot of clarity, a lot of sharpness, and a really, really nice looking image. And for the 4K 60 mode, which I believe is going to be the highest frame rate that it offers, because they obviously don't want to handicap the Sony a7 III, which can do up to 120 frames, it looks like the 4K 60 will be oversampled from a 4.8K Super 35 mode, and that'll be in 10-bit 422. So if all goes well, the 4K 60 should also look pretty sharp and nice. One thing that I am excited about is that it says that it'll be able to do 4K streaming and that it will be able to do 60p streaming at full HD or 1080p. Now, from what I've read, it will be able to do this kind of streaming without a capture card like a Cam Link, and will be able to do it strictly via the USB cable that you would plug in from the camera to the computer. And if this is accurate, then I will be really excited to see how this is going to change video calls and streaming going down the line, because right now you have to purchase like a $300 capture card just so you can get your image, you know, live streaming on the internet. So I want to see if it's reliable and I want to see if it's good, but if that's the case, that is a huge upgrade. We're going to have S-Cinetone, we're going to have 10-bit 422, and S-Log3.Cine, all the amazing offerings that the FX6 and the A7 A7S3 has. But one thing that I'm really excited about for this camera is the upgrade from 8-bit to 10-bit. Now, a lot of you have been really kind in saying that my color grades always look like they're 10-bit, but to be honest, I've always had a bit of a limitation pushing the color grade of the a7 III before I really start to see it break, and that's typically when I shoot an S-Log2. So I'm really, really excited about the upgrade to 10-bit. I think that is the main selling point for me, along with the fact that it's going to have 4K 60, because I really want to have a small, lightweight travel camera that I can take on adventures with me that is going to be able to record 10-bit. It's essentially going to have the same body design and heatsink and all of that as the A7 S3, so I'm not really going to jump into that. If you've watched any video on that camera, then I just think that we should all expect that it will be the same for the A7 IV. And that means we're going to have full-size HDMI, we're going to have the articulating screen, which I'm really excited about. We're gonna have the ability to use SD cards as well as CF Express Type A cards, which will cost you an arm and a leg. And essentially we're gonna have everything that the Sony a7 S3 offers minus 4K 120, but we gain a better photo megapixel count. And the biggest part is that it's gonna be $2,500. Now that's $1,000 cheaper than the Sony a7 S3 and is ultimately why I held off on buying that camera. Because when I did see the price, I thought it was kind of over the top. Although it is an amazing camera and it is capable of so much, you know, you could just spend a couple thousand dollars more and get essentially a pro cinema camera with variable NDs and XLR inputs. So to be able to see this camera come out and have it be $1,000 cheaper really, really excites me. Now let's talk business. And by business, I mean, when is this shipping and when will it actually be in people's hands? Because we all know Sony has been really predominantly bad at getting cameras into people's hands these days. So it says that shipments are gonna start first week of December, but what does that actually mean? Well, we know there's a chip shortage. We know that the FX6 has been essentially out of stock and backordered for over a year now. And it's still possible to get the FX3 and the A7S III, but I have seen them kind of teeter in and out of being in stock on major retailer websites. I think that reaching out to your local camera shop or smaller camera shops is gonna be a better bet than going with these major retailers, because you know everybody and their mom is about to hop on B&H to try and order this camera. So that's pretty much about it. I'm super excited about this camera. I haven't been this excited about a camera in a long time, since the FX6, to be honest. I really love the A7 III. It honestly changed my entire workflow and who I was as a cinematographer because of how amazing and versatile it was. So I'm really looking forward to just upgrading that to another level, just so I can get a little bit more quality, a little bit more dynamic range, and just a better color science, because although I love the A7 III and I've really solidified my workflow, I am tired of breaking that 8-bit footage apart. And I think this camera will probably match a little bit better with the FX6, so we'll see. Anyways, I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts on the A7 IV. Are you excited about the release? Is there something missing there that you wish you would have seen? If so, make sure to drop them down in the comments below and I'll make sure to chat you up on those. And as always, I appreciate you watching and I'm looking forward to the next one. And until then, peace. Can we talk about my dog right now? What is she doing? She's just coming in and out while I try to record this video. I'm never gonna get this done, is what's gonna happen.